chapter 1. We got down last week to verse 19. Now, I said this last week, but it needs to be. If you are born again, you only have one book of the Bible, the book of James would be a book for you to live by. So, James hits every one of us by what we live. This is something, you know, that is kind of amazing to me about some people. You know, they can read the book of the Bible, whatever it is, and whatever it says, they say, well, I've been saved and that don't apply to me. Everything in here applies to me. If it didn't, why would God put it in there? God does not do anything for nothing. It's like healing. When God heals a person, he don't heal that person for their benefit. He heals that person for the kingdom's benefit. That he would get the glory, the honor. Once again, this is the map to get the presence of God. So he said, verse 19 said, wherefore, my beloved brethren, let every man be swift to hear and slow to speak, slow to wrath. That is some good instructions that he's giving us. The word wrath means anger, amplified Bible usually as anger. Let's go to Ecclesiastes chapter 5. Ecclesiastes chapter 5, 1 and 2. Solomon says, keep thy foot when thou goest to the house of God, and be more ready to hear than to give sacrifice of food. For they consider not that they do evil. Be not rash with thy mouth, and let not thine heart be hasty to utter anything before God. For God is in heaven, and thou upon the earth, and therefore let thy words be few. Well, so many people, a lot of their problem is what they say. I'm hearing too many people today actually cursing themselves. I don't mean in profanity, but what they say. You can't talk about sickness all the time, people, and live in hell. You're going to have what you say, Jesus said. You know? Go back to Genesis 11 and 6. This is the Tower of Babel. And the Lord said, behold, thy people is one, and they have all one language, and this they begin to do, and now nothing will be restrained from them which they have imagined to do. In other words, they were all saying what they were going to do, and they're going to do it. And the same is true with us today. You hear so many people, as I said, talking negative about themselves, and they're actually living a negative life. Glory in their sickness. You know, one said, oh, every day we need to have some of the Word in us. Word and prayer. You've got to keep your spirit filled up. Because, like you say, these people will wire you down in a heartbeat. In Revelation 19, verse 15, Jesus, you're the righteous judge. It said, out of his mouth goeth a sharp sword, that with it he should smite the nation, and shall rule them with a rod of iron, he treadeth the winepress of the fierceness of their wrath, and Almighty God. The point I'm wanting to make here is, a sharp sword is his word. Verse 20 said, for the wrath of man worketh not the righteousness of God. As I said a minute ago, that word wrath means anger. Have you ever seen a time that there's as many angry people as there is today? Upset. Mad at this. Don't like that. You name it. Nobody's satisfied. Like I said a while ago, it's a lot of the people in those church week after week after week. Well, if we are serving the Prince of Peace, shouldn't we have peace? No. The book of Hebrews tells us, he says, follow after peace and holiness, without which no man shall see the Lord. So peace is as necessary as holiness to see the Lord. That's what bothers me about a lot of people. According to that verse, there's going to be a lot of people I know won't make it. Because they're always upset about something. But you know, we know who the enemy is that keeps us upset. And Jesus, the Bible tells us, God says, you know, we are to submit ourselves to God, you know, resist the devil, James is telling us that, and he will flee. Then there comes that old dirty word everybody don't like. Submit. People don't want to submit to nothing. Makes no good. I heard a church meeting one time say, ain't nobody telling me what to do. Listen. There's time we gotta listen to other people. They know more than we do. Verse 21 said, he said, wherefore lay apart all filthiness and superfluity, that word superfluity means overflowing of naughtiness, and receive with meekness. You notice that? The word meekness also means humbleness, the engrafted word which is able to save your soul. The word engrafted means to be implanted. Naughtiness means badness or depravity. You know. So, James says here, lay all that stuff aside. You know, when you take on everybody else's problems and this and that and the other, it will weigh you down. Something that's seared over, it's hard. That's the reason why, we see people doing all this violence and everything and killing people, you name it. And you think, how in the world can somebody do that? Conscience is seared. Go back and read the Old Testament. Any time that Israel turned from God, other gods came in. And so that's what's happened to America. America has turned from God. So these other gods have come in. See, what people don't understand, let's take the demoniac, all those devils that Jesus cast out of them, they went into the hogs, and the hogs went into the sea. Well, the hogs died, but them demons didn't. We're still dealing with them. They go on from generation to generation, and people don't understand that. I mean, it always amazes me. A man he was one of the best I ever saw. He could tell you about every king and everything else of the Old Testament, but he made this statement. He said, I don't believe there are any devils today. Thank you. We can see that today. And, but there is going to be a remnant. God's always had a remnant now. I mean, they have tried all through the centuries to do away with the Word of God, but it's forever settled in heaven and nobody's going to change it. No. I mean, there are judgments for us if we add to or take away. You know, we have to accept it, what God says. And it hurts me just as bad as it does anybody else, some of it does. It hurts my flesh. This is one of the things that the devil is doing today. The devil is doing his best to destroy the family. And so we're having children today that do not have discipline. And now we're seeing the repercussions of all that in all these big cities and all this violence that they're having. Even the government says now, you're not supposed to paddle your child. Well, the Bible tells us we're not to spoil it, you know, tear the rod and spoil the child. So, maybe an older person that has gone through something that will help you. But now, verse 22 said, "But be ye doers of the word and not hearers only, deceiving your own self." The worst kind of deception that you'll ever have is self-deception. When you think that you are totally right, but you're totally wrong. You get into you find a person that is self-deceived, very seldom will you ever change it. Because they think they are totally right and you're wrong. And it's the same way with the Bible. You know, these people that have been brought up in nominalism and everything, and you tell them one day Jesus Christ is coming back riding on a white horse and he's going to have a 1,000-year reign upon the earth, you will not change those people because they think they are totally right. You know, the only people that you will ever change is somebody that is truly seeking God. Well, go back to Jesus. How many of the scribes, Pharisees, Sadducees, how many of them did he change? Very few. Same way today. You know, Solomon says, what has been will be. Verse 23 says, for if any be a hearer of the word and not a doer, he is like unto a man beholding his natural face in a glass. For he beholdeth himself and goeth his way, and straightway forgetteth what manner of man he was. How many people in America today that will be sitting in churches hearing the word of God, and as soon as they walk out the door, they'll do just opposite of what they heard? When we hear the word, we have got to put it down in here and let it make a change in our life. People have got, seem like they've got to see the think, the mindset that church is just entertainment. It's a good music or a fellowship meal or you name it. We come here to serve the Most High God. I'm not here for any entertainment. The music should be that we worship Him. It's not to entertain me. People say, "Well, I don't like going to that church. They don't have good music." Well, do they have good worship? That's the problem. Right. 25 said, "But whoso looketh into the perfect law of liberty," the word liberty also means freedom, "and continueth therein, he being not a forgetful hearer, but a doer of the work, this man is blessed in his deeds." The word law there means the Torah, the first five books of Moses in the Old Testament. And it also means teaching or instruction. Now you got to understand, when James was writing this letter, he didn't have the New Testament. All he had was the Torah, the old, what we call it, the law and the prophets. That's all he had. But he said, that if we will abide in this law or in this word, we're going to be blessed in what we do. How many people do you see today that seem like everything they do goes wrong? Well, are they living according to the book? No. He said, he calls it the perfect law of liberty. The word perfect means complete. And the word work means religious and moral obligation. So you're going to be blessed even what you do for God. You're going to be blessed in what you do for your community and the people around you. 26 said, "If any man among you seem to be religious and bridleth not his tongue, but deceiveth his own heart, this man's religion is in vain." This once again, this hits us all. We all, and James is going to continue this in the next chapter, we all have problems with this thing called the tongue. It hurts. The word religious means ceremonious in worship. Go to Matthew 11 and 28. This is Jesus speaking here. He said, "Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest." That word heavy laden in the Greek also means overburdened with ceremony. Now you remember, during Jesus' time, the Jews had made so many rules and regulations, they couldn't even keep their own rules. That's what he's talking about. And a lot of times, churches have done the same thing today. They have got so much ceremony We've left God plumb out of it. We need, when we come together, we need to let the Holy Ghost have total control. Because when He has total control, it will not be wrong. But, just like it was with the Jews, as long as man had control in it, you know, everything was a mess. Even Jesus, I believe it's in John 16, I believe it is. Anyway, Jesus told his disciples, he said, they'll kill you and think they're doing God a service. And it happened, with Saul, which is called Paul. He was going out and getting the Christians and bringing them in for trials, putting them in prison, whatever, And he thought, sure, he was doing the right thing. And this is what happens with religious people. They will not do it according to what God wants. They do it according to tradition. Verse 27. This is what he says here. Pure religion and undefiled before God and the Father is this, to visit the fathers and the widows in their afflictions and to keep himself unspotted from the world. I know there's a lot of churches now that do have feeding programs and this and that and this, but the way things are set up in our country today, we let the government take care of most of that. There are all kinds of social programs and this, what I'm talking about. But here's the one that we really need to look at. He said, your religion is keep yourself unspotted from the world. We're not to act like the world. We're not to do the things that they do. That's why things are in the shape they're in today. But here, we've come up to a time, just like I believe in Isaiah, he said, they're going to say, right is wrong and wrong is right. And we've come up to that time today. Just like it was back in the early part of the church age. They thought all the bad things that happened was because of the Christians. And there's people today that they think if they could get rid of the church, everything would turn out to be okay. They don't understand. When the church is gone, according to the book of Revelation, then all hell breaks loose. Well, our time's up there. We'll pick up God willing with chapter 2 next week.